The 1971 Stanford Prison Experiment has long been considered a window into the human soul, into how ordinary and innocent people can be transformed by circumstance into willing tyrants who abuse their powers freely to commit horrors and atrocities. It has become a cornerstone study in the scientific literature on genocide, evil, and aggression. I mean, you would really struggle to find any introductory psychology textbook today that doesn't make mention of the 1971 Stanford Prison Experiment. It has been almost 50 years now, and yet to this day, the Stanford Prison Experiment is often cited uncritically, unfortunately. There have been even multiple feature films made about it, multiple. It's obvious that this particular study has captured the public's imagination, for obvious reasons. It was very dramatic and, well, people, they love drama. The experiment took 24 healthy male college students, dividing them into guards and prisoners through a coin flick. Before placing them into a mock prison environment, the converted basement of the Stanford University Psychology Department. It was planned that the experiment would last for 2 whole weeks, however, 6 days into the study, the lead researchers decided to pull the plug and terminate their fancy experiment. Why? It was allegedly done to safeguard the best interests of the study participants. According to Zimbardo, the lead researcher, and his colleagues, the experiment had in 6 short days transformed the ordinary college students into tyrannical prison guards, who would constantly harass and berate the prisoners. The prisoners, on the other hand, had for the most part accepted their role as prisoners, apparently forgetting that they were actually college students. The research scientists quickly proclaimed that their study showed just how quickly people came to accept social roles they found themselves in, and how authority and power can push people to act in ways they would not typically act in their everyday lives. Well, well, bold conclusions, right? Sadly though, the Stanford Prison Experiment is one example of bad science. And if you watch this video, you'll find out exactly why you can't trust the conclusions from the Stanford Prison Experiment, and why it became so influential despite being so bad. So stick around, you won't regret it, I hope anyway. But here's the tiny mandatory bit about Dr. Tell Me Why. Maybe, just maybe, I'll convince you guys to subscribe and welcome you guys to my YouTube squad. The coolest squad there is. But seriously, Dr. Tell Me Why is a health education YouTube channel where I make accessible and engaging medical content for you guys to enjoy. The idea is twofold: to get you guys thinking so your brains can grow bigger, not literally, that would be bad, that would be very bad, and to entertain you guys with my very mediocre sense of humor. So subscribe, you never know, this could be the best thing to happen to your YouTube feed in a really, really long time. So why does the Stanford Prison Experiment get on my nerves so much? So much that I've decided to make an entire YouTube video about it. Why do I say it's an example of bad science? Well, for starters, the research scientist Zimbardo and his team had quite a few hidden agendas before they started the experiment. Zimbardo himself said in an interview in 2009 that he was anti-prisons and that he had sympathies for prisoners before conducting his 1971 study. Which is obviously very noble. That in of itself is not the issue. The issue is allowing these sympathies to bias your study design. Which is precisely what happened. Zimbardo and his colleagues designed the Stanford Prison Experiment from its outset to be a live demonstration of the toxicity of the US prison system. And it all started with the ad they placed in newspapers looking for study participants. The ad stated that what they were looking for was participants for a psychology study of prison life. A 2007 recreation of that same newspaper ad found that the inclusion of the words prison life led to the volunteers coming forward being more likely to exhibit traits of authoritarianism and narcissism, and were also more likely to show aggressive tendencies. These are traits that not all of us necessarily have. And if your study sample, your participants are biased, you can't use the results from that study to make general overarching conclusions about the general population as a whole. But the study design biases did not stop there, you wish. Zimbardo, the lead researcher, appointed himself as prison superintendent, effectively becoming a part of the study himself. He would often berate the guards, telling them that they should toughen up and treat the prisoners more aggressively. According to one of the guards, John Marks, Zimbardo went out of his way to create tension and often coached or manipulated the guards into being cruel. And while all the guards are believed in popular culture to have become cruel, exacting very harsh punishments onto the prisoners, the truth is far more complex than that. The majority, 2/3 of the guards, did not show any sadistic tendencies whatsoever. Only 4 guards in total abused their power at any one time during the experiment. One of those bad guards, David Eshelman, was a drama student, and he said he consciously took steps to create this bad guard persona because it was the results that he thought Zimbardo was looking for. Telling reporter Ben Blum, "I believed that I was doing what the researchers wanted me to do." And according to one of the prisoners, prisoner 8612, the prison felt phony. Stellar review. Add this to the fact that attempts to replicate the results of the study, like the 2002 BBC prison study, yielded dramatically different results. And the fact that for some obscure reason, only about 15 hours of video recordings are available from the study out of the total 6 days. It's hypothesized that Zimbardo and his colleagues were only interested in filming the dramatic bits of the study, apparently not finding it necessary to film 85% of the study, period, where the guards and the prisoners apparently just got along, nothing really happened, and the prison experience was more or less mundane. Basically, the Stanford Prison Experiment is not to be trusted. So, next question, how did such a terrible experiment with many design flaws get ingrained in the public imagination, eventually becoming one of the most influential psychology studies like ever? Well, blame Zimbardo, blame him for everything. On the final day of the study, before he had time to look at any of the data or any of the results from the study, he sent a press release to local and national newspapers declaring that his study, the Stanford Prison Experiment, was a clear message for prison reform. Moreover, later in 1971, he gave a very dramatic testimony before Congress, again on the same subject, prison reform. This was well before any scientific paper on the study was published, before the study could be peer-reviewed by other scientists in the same field, before it could be critically assessed and appraised for its results and its flaws. Zimbardo basically created hype and everyone just believed him. That's sad, if you ask me. I hope you guys enjoyed this roller coaster ride and realized that not all science is good science. Some science is bad, but that's perfectly fine so long as we learn from that bad science and move forward from that. Thank you guys for making it to the very end with me today. I'm not gonna lie, it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. But if you want to help me even more with the YouTube algorithm, then please give this video a like so that YouTube can recommend this video to more people. If you really love this video, however, and you want to see more from my channel and more from me, then I recommend you subscribe. If you subscribe, I'll give you top tips on living a healthier life. I'll tell you about all these fascinating medical conditions and present to you the latest groundbreaking medical research, all in one place. And that place is right here. Thank you guys, love you all to bits, and see you all next Saturday.